In this example, we're given the universal set contains the whole numbers from 1 through 30. A, B, and C are subsets containing the elements given here. We want to list the elements in set A union C, which means you want to find the elements in A or C, then find the elements in set A intersect B, which would be the elements in A and B, then find the elements in set A union B union C, meaning find the elements in A or B or C, and then finally, we want to find the elements in set A intersect B intersect C, which would be the elements in set A and set B and set C. Let's set this up using a Venn diagram. Let's begin by identifying the elements that would be in this region here that would be in all three sets. So we're looking for a number or element that is in all three sets. And notice how there are no elements listed that are in all three sets, meaning in set A, B, and C. And therefore, this region here will have no elements in it. And therefore, this region here will not have any elements in it. So now let's find the elements that are only in A and B, which would be this region here. So looking at A and B, notice how they both contain element 10 and 14. So 10 and 14 would be in this region here. Now let's find the elements that are only in B and C, which would be this region here. Looking at B and C, notice how they both contain 4, 5, 8, and 12. So those four elements would be in this region here. Again, 4, 5, 8, and 12. And now let's find the elements that would be only in A and C, this region here. So looking at A and C, notice how they both contain 11. And those are the only two elements they have in common. So 11 goes in this region here. And now we'll list the elements that are only in set A, only in set B, and only in set C. So looking at set A, notice 13 and 25 would only be in A. Looking at set B, elements 17, 19, 22, and 30 would only be in B. Looking at set C, the elements 1, 6, 9, and 23 are only in set C. Now remember, our universal set contains the whole numbers from 1 through 30, which are not all contained in these sets here. We don't actually need to know which elements from the universal set and not in sets A, B, or C. If we wanted to find those, we could count from 1 through 30 and determine which elements are missing. Just to complete our Venn diagram, I will go ahead and list these. All these elements here are in the universal set, but not in A, B, or C. But we really don't have to know this in order to determine. Let's go ahead and clean this up a little bit. Let's erase some of these highlights. Okay, let's find the elements in A union C, which would be all the elements in A or C. All the elements in A or C would be all the elements in this region here. We do want to list these from least to greatest, so we'll have to be careful here. We have 1, 4, 5, 6, and then we have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And then we have 23 and 25. And I think we got them all. Now let's find A intersect B, which should be all the elements that are in set A and set B. Well, the elements in set A and set B would be the elements in this region here. Notice how this set only contains 10 and 14. Next, we want to find A union B union C, meaning all the elements in A or B or C, which should be all the elements in this region here. And again, we do want to list these from least to greatest, but we can actually use the fact that we already know A union C, and using this set here, we can just add in the elements only in B, these four elements here. All the other ones are already listed here in A union C. So we'd have 1, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now we have 17, 19, and then 22, then 23, 25, and then 30. And then finally, we want A intersect B intersect C, which would be the elements that are in A and B and C, which is actually where we started our Venn diagram. That was this region here. There are no elements there, so we call this the empty set. Normally we express the empty set using, there are two common ways to indicate empty set. One way is to have our brackets with nothing in them. Another way is to use this symbol here. But for our online homework, we actually have to type in DNE for the empty set. I hope you found this helpful.